Here we go then, Jed Forrest with the kickoff, and it's straight into the basket of Bruce McNeil. And Russ Goodfellow coming up, what was to be a massive hit, but didn't work out, and the ball's been passed out to Keith Davis. But Ian Hurd, the referee, said that that pass went forward there from Bruce McNeil to Keith Davis, because Keith Davis was giving it the old toot toot, because he was just seeing the try line beckoning him up the stand side. But it's been brought back by referee Mr. Ian Hurd, and in the hands of Russ Goodfellow now. 28 seconds gone in this final, Jed Forrest versus Hoyk. Ball now into the scrum, and it's come back Chisholm feeds it along the line to Lewis Young, his brother Gregor Young on the break across the halfway line, makes it up to 10 metre line. He's still going, feeds it back inside to Lewis Young at the 22, feeds it inside to Ian Chisholm, still going forward. He's been tackled well there though. Ball should come back on the Jed Forrest side, should it, or has it been secured by Hoyk? I think there's been a good bit of smuggling there done by Hoyk, and it has indeed come back on the Hoyk side now with Cottrell long line to Michael Robertson. Robertson takes the tackle well, back inside to Cottrell, then back inside to, I think that's Neil Rennick there on the bus there, up the centre of the field, and he's got Lewis Young to beat, and in fact he's beaten him, he's taken him on, and he's gone all the way for the post. Lewis Young chasing, he's grabbed him by the collar, and he's stopped him just short, a mere shot of the try line. The ball's there if somebody wants to take it. We're a minute and a half into this game, still 0-0, the ball's there, it's come out, and it's been secured by Jed Forrest. Well, I tell you what, Neil Rennick looked as if he was scoring there under the post, but he was grabbed and has been taken on now by Gary Johnston. Ball went forward and it's been fed out to Keith Davis on that far side, and he's going to go in for the score, the first score of this final. Hoyk 5, Jed Forrest 0.
Well, it's been absolutely electric straight from kickoff, straight from that Bruce McNeil collection and that driving run over halfway in the opening 7 seconds. Of course, he scored a try in, what was it, 7 seconds in an earlier tie in the competition, but Hoyk taking the game to Jed, and Bruce McNeil attacking right from the front there, and Jed Forrest was stretched, day in turn stretched Hoyk though down that far side right hand channel with Lewis Young and Gregor Young linking up extremely well, both showing tremendous balance there. But as you were saying before the start of this one, no quarter asked or given, and that's been by far and away the most exciting opening 90 seconds or so we've watched in any tie so far. That's not a bad conversion attempt, but it is wide, but there's going to be a few tired players at the end of this one, because that was an extraordinary start to a final,
certainly was,
of a game of sevens. End-to-end stuff, Kenny.
Certainly was, and Lewis Young looks as if he's injured himself there in that last-ditch effort to stop Neil Rennick scoring the try. But Chiku Woods has been on the field of play, and he's rubbed the magic sponge on his leg, and he's back into the foray. And Goodfellow now feeds it along the line to Chisholm to Lewis Young. Lewis Young's been tackled, though, in his own 22. He spilled the ball forward. In fact, referee's saying that it's come off a Hoyk hand, and it's going to be a Jed Forrest put into the scrum here about a couple of metres inside their own 22. The sun has actually come out here at Mansfield Park. We've had 4 seasons in one day. It's been bitterly cold, it's rained, it's been sleet, it's been drizzle, and now the sun's come out to grace the final. 3.5 minutes gone in this final. Ross Goodfellow with the put in, picked up by Ian Chisholm now. Ian Chisholm's been caught though on his own 22, but Bruce McNeil's been penalised for not releasing. Quickly taken, Darren Gillespie now. Darren Gillespie comes out his own 22, looking for some support, finds some support there from Lucia. In fact, it's Michael Weekly inside to Andrew Nagle. Looks as if he's going backwards there. Ross Goodfellow feeds Michael Weekly cuts back inside there. He's been tackled well though. Ross Goodfellow comes in, clears out, and ball's picked up now by Nagle along line to Darren Gillespie to Chisholm, half break there, but he's been caught by Rory Hutton on the 10 metre line there, and it's been picked up to Darren Gillespie, but the ball's knocked forward there. Referee was playing advantage, but the ball was knocked forward there by Andrew Nagle, and a wee bit of afters there as well involving Weekly and Rory Hutton. But it's going to be a scrum to Hoyk here just on the 10 metre line. We've played 4.5 minutes of this final. Hoyk 5, Jed Forrest 0. Just 10 metres inside the Jed half. Cottrell with the put into scrum, comes back now. Bit of a shambles, but it's back in the hands of Rory Hutton, Gary Johnson cuts back inside there. He's made 2 or 3 metres there into the Jed Forrest half. It's going to come back. In fact, Jed Forrest being penalised for not rolling away from the tackler. Rory Hutton now, quick tap and go. Cottrell, he's got Michael Robertson in this bit, he's not going to need him. Cuts back inside, and he's going to go in here for try number two for Hoyt. Greg Cottrell scores try number two for Hoyt there with 5 minutes gone on the clock. Cottrell in to the left-hand side of the post. He cut back inside. He just had Lewis Young to beat, and he beat him well. Cut back inside and in for the score. Hoyt 10, Jed Forrest 0.
Yes, great piece of individual play there inside the Jed 22 from Cottrell. And this afternoon, you know, he's been very much at the heart of a lot that Hoyt have been doing in terms of building up attacks and in terms of finishing things off. He's got some tries to his name in this tournament, and that one is converted as well. So there's a real atmosphere now in Mansfield Park. We did say a little earlier on in the tournament there was something missing, there was something lacking. Well, certainly the blue Dutch paper has been lit now, and with Hoyt in this situation, Jed Forrest coming into this match had only conceded in the most number of points in one game was 10 against Kelso. Here go Hoyt again though.
Michael Robertson, that ball, it was a guy sick looking kickoff there from Neil Rennick, and Michael Robertson was first to react and has been picked up now by Bruce McNeil. Bruce McNeil's away. Bruce McNeil is going for under the sticks here, and Bruce McNeil touches down. That came from what looked like a really sick kickoff from Neil Rennick, but it just sat up nicely for Michael Robertson. Robertson took it on, and then it came into the hands of Bruce McNeil just outside the Jed Forrest 22, and Bruce McNeil goes in for try number three for Hoyt.
And again, it's a case of being in the right place at the right time a lot of the time, but he still had some work to do just in and around that 22 when he picked the ball up, when he received possession, and he accelerated away, and he got in behind the Jed side and round the Jed side. And one thing that I've said, not only in this tournament but in the Galloway tournament, and we witnessed at Melrose, Jed had a very well organised defence. When they were not in possession of the ball, they were able to keep a tight defence, and that's why they haven't conceded many points. Well, Hoyt are opening up Jed's defence right, left and centre at this moment in time, and the Jed players with hands and hips, we felt that perhaps they might be the fresher of the two. Hoyt have certainly come out and hit them with three sucker punches in the opening 7 minutes of this final. Of course, 10 minutes each way.
7 minutes gone, and it's Hoyt 19, Jed Forrest 0, and Hoyt on the attack again, and it's going to be Cottrell. Cottrell's gone in, and that just came straight from the restart. Michael Robertson gathered the ball from the restart. Neil Rennick putting the high ball up. Michael Robertson collecting the ball, and then the ball's fed out to Cottrell, and Cottrell scampers in for his second try of the final. Jed 0, Hoyt 24, 7.5 minutes on the clock.
And the Jed players are just looking at each other thinking, what's happened here? You know, they've been completely opened up. I mean, this is no fluke. I mean, this first half so far, that 7, almost 8 minutes old, has been totally controlled by the home side, totally controlled by the host. This, you know, Hoyt side, this group of players that seem just to come good every time they have their own sevens, and they've had this tremendous record of consecutive wins. That conversion just goes wide, but I mean, that's lifted the crowd, and that must really give the Hoyt players at 24-0, as the Tano announcer reads out the score, 24-0, a big cheer goes up. They must give them tremendous belief that they can win yet another Hoyt sevens.
Yeah, here we go then, Neil Rennick again. It's another high hanging ball there, and again it's been secured by Hoyt. Bruce McNeil with it. Bruce McNeil feeds it back in. Rory Hutton now. Rory Hutton has a wee dance there, and he's been tackled well though, and Hoyt come back in to try and secure the ball, but the ball's went loose. But Jed Forrest has been penalised there, and in fact Ian Hurd is marching them back for it appears that somebody said something that he didn't quite like. Cottrell now with the retake. Keith Davis tries to cut open there, 10 metres inside the 22, and it's been secured now by Jed Forrest. Jed Forrest should come up with this ball. In fact, the referee playing a bit of advantage now for Jed Forrest. Ian Chisholm along line to Robert Hogg, but Robert Hogg fumbles it there. He's just come onto the field of play, and big fumble there from Robert Hogg there, but referee taking it back for the advantage on the far side of the field, and it's going to be a penalty to Jed Forrest, quickly taken by Ross Goodfellow. Goodfellow feeds it along the line. It's taken on there by Chisholm. Chisholm breaks two tackles there, feeds it inside, but again it's been lost. It's been knocked on there by Lewis Young, unfortunately. 9.5 minutes on the clock, and Jed Forrest is just not quite going their way, and it's Hoyt 24, Jed Forrest 0. 9.5 minutes on the clock, so we've got a scrum now just about 15 metres inside the Jed Forrest half, and it's going to be a Hoyt put into the scrum. Greg Cottrell with the ball, and he's just getting himself sorted out. So front rows go down there. Cottrell puts the ball in now. Nearly 10 minutes up. Ball's come loose and Cottrell's trying to secure it there, but Jed boys are like all over him like a bad rash there, and it's going to come back. It's a penalty because Cottrell was holding on there. So Goodfellow, the tap and go, feeds it along the line to Chisholm. Chisholm switches it back there, and it's fed wildly across to this side to Lewis Young. Lewis Young on the stand side here, taking on Michael Robertson, but he's been tackled there. Ball's out there for somebody if they want it, and it's been hacked through by Keith Davis, and in fact it's a penalty to Jed Forrest, quickly taken by Gregor Young. Gregor Young now, where's he going with this? He's looking for some support. Support, he finds it in the shape of brother Lewis Young, and now it's been tackled there, and it's going to come back hopefully on the Jed Forrest side. In fact, Mr. Hurd looks at his watch and he says he's seen enough of this first half. He played 10 minutes and 30 seconds, and Jed Forrest 0, Hoyt 24. So here we go now, the ball with Neil Rennick on the halfway line, and off we go, second half of the Hoyt final. Hoyt 24, Jed 0. And that ball's been hacked through there by Gary Johnson. Gary Johnson picks it up and he's in for the score. Unbelievable stuff from Hoyt. Hoyt 29, Jed 0. 16 seconds on the clock, nearly as quick as Bruce McNeil's try in the semi-final, but Gary Johnson in for the score there. Hoyt 29, Jed 0. Jed just cut wide open there right from the kickoff.
Yeah, and whatever was said at halftime in the Jed Forrest camp, well, certainly they, as you say, they, I don't know what they were expecting from Hoyt, but Hoyt doing exactly at the start of the second what they did all the way through the first half, being very direct, pressing game, and again an exceptionally good breakaway, no giving up on a lost cause there, and in for a score, and that's not a bad conversion attempt at all. That's successful, that's another 2 points. Well, Jed Forrest 0, Hoyt 31. We've only played a minute of the second half of this final.
Stuart, it's not what you'd anticipated here this afternoon, I can tell you, because Jed Forrest, they've looked like the form side. That's well taken by Gregor Young from the kickoff, but the referee says that there was an elbow used as well, and he's penalised Darren Gillespie there. He says there was an elbow used when he was going up along with Gregor Young to take that kickoff. Cottrell now feeds it inside to Keith Davis. Keith Davis along the line to Gary Johnson. Gary Johnson to Hutton. Hutton, Gary Johnson, and then it's out to Neil Rennick on that far side of the field. Rennick trying to break away from the tackler. Rennick into the 22. Has he got support? He's looking for the support. But that ball's just been hacked by one of the Jed players on that far side of the field. Jed should come up with the ball here. Very, very important that Jed get a score very, very quickly now. Ross Goodfellow, where's he going to go with the ball? He's looking for the opportunity to break away here, but opportunity's not there. He's been tackled well within his own 22 there, and it's coming back on the Jed side again. Jed looking to get themselves out of trouble here. Lewis Young on that far side of the field feeds it to Robert Hogg. Robert Hogg sees gap up the middle of the field now. Robert Hogg, he's got lots of gas, he's got gas to burn, feeds it inside to Gregor Young. Gregor Young, but he's been tackled well by Cottrell there. So the ball now should come back on the Jed side. In fact, referee Hurd is saying that there's a hand being used in there illegally, and it's going to be a penalty to Jed Forrest. Robert Hogg with the penalty feeds it inside Darren Gillespie to Lewis Young, but he loses it there forward. There's a bit of fisticuffs going on now as well. It's all a bit silly here. Might as well just go on with the rugby. I think Neil Rennick, he's been tackled there. Fed inside to Bruce McNeil. Bruce McNeil breaks the tackle of Gregor Young. Bruce McNeil's away down the middle of the park here. Feeds it out to Cottrell. Cottrell inside the 22. He doesn't need any help there, and he's in for the score. Hoyt 36, Jed 0. 2 minutes gone. In fact, 3 minutes gone in this second half.
Yeah, the scores just keep coming for Hoyt, it has to be said. And Jed Forrest, I mean, the players are hands and hips, not me-gub expressions on faces. They don't really know what's gone wrong. There's not one individual that's the fault out there. They just haven't, you know, been at the races in this final. This does happen to even the best of teams. They can have off days. But the one thing is, every time Hoyt have gone forward, Jed Forrest have been punished. And that is crucial, because a lot of teams will press and press, but not necessarily break through the defence. Hoyt have been able to do that practically every time they've attacked Jed Forrest in the final. That's why this is becoming so emphatic. The conversion attempt missed. That there's a real sort of party atmosphere beginning to build in the stand, with a large contingent of home supporters here really enjoying this. Jed Forrest fans will be bitterly disappointed, because for the vast majority of the Kings series so far, this is the last thing they've had to witness.
Yeah, Robertson's off and Russell's on. That's taken by Gregor Young, but the ball's been spilled loose and it's picked up by Russell here on the stand side. He's fed it to Bruce McNeil. Bruce McNeil along to Rory Hutton. Rory Hutton's got support from Gary Johnson. Gary Johnson tries the overhead pass there, but it's been picked up by Cottrell. Cottrell with his hat-trick in this final. Three tries for Greg Cottrell already. Fed inside there to Neil Rennick. Neil Rennick breaks one tackle, feeds it inside to Russell, but unfortunately he just knocks it on there. And it should come back here on the Jed Forest side. Referee Mr. Hurd playing advantage. It does. Michael Weekly passes it along the line there. It's Robert Hogg on that far side of the field. He's got Lewis Young in support, but Lewis Young, would you believe it, he knocks it on yet again. Referee playing advantage. In fact, no, his whistle goes. Bruce McNeil had secured that ball, but it's going to be a put into the scrum. Hoyk ball, Greg Cottrell with the put into the scrum. 4.5 minutes gone in the second half of the Hoyk Sevens final. Jed 0, Hoyk 36. Hoyk having scored 6 tries in this final already, and we've still got 5 minutes to play. So Cottrell looking to get this ball into the scrum, and Hoyk making 2 or 3 changes now to their players on the field. It's Rory Hutton that's coming off. I think he's had a good afternoon, and he's waving to the fans down at the far end of the field there. There's a bit of banter going on as he was trying to take the kick. So Lewis Young now with the ball, feeds it to Robert Hogg. Robert Hogg looking for support, but Jed all at sixes and sevens at the minute, and Hoyk tackling really, really hard here, and it's come up Michael Weekly feeds it inside to Goodfellow. Nowhere to go. He's got McNeil on his back and somebody else round his legs. He can't run if somebody's got your legs. Ross Goodfellow. Robert Hogg comes up with the ball, feeds it inside Gregor Young. Now Gregor Young breaks one tackle. Can he break the second tackle? No, he can't. He feeds it back up there, but it's gone a bit loose here, and Ross Goodfellow there, in fact Darren Gillespie, as the ball's been played to him there, just knocks it on, and it's just not going Jed's way. Stuart McFarlane, when it's not going your way with 6 minutes gone in the second half, it's not going your way.
Yeah, I mean, there'll be a lot of Jed supporters now thinking, well, just blow the full time whistle, you know, it's at 36 points to nil. Hoyk certainly enjoying the occasion, and as you rightly pointed out earlier on, it means Rory Hutton coming off. A number of players, they'll be checking their fitness and how they're feeling ahead of a Border League final, but they want to obviously experience this right to the end, because this long run of successive wins at the road tournament is set to continue. And Jed, I mean, they'll be bitterly disappointed that this is how the final has turned out, because they fell away against Saracens in the second half of the Melrose final last week, having won Gala. They've never been in this final at all.
They haven't been in this final. You're absolutely right, and that ball just skewed out the side again, and referee Mr. Hurd's asking for it to go in. This will be the third attempt that Greg Cottrell's had just to get this ball into the scrum here, and in fact there's got to be a fourth attempt very shortly. And you kind of buy a scenario like this. Their seventh final in a row at their own sevens, and won four the last four, and it looks very much like it certainly is that they're going to win their fifth final. So here we go, Jed Forest now on the attack, but the ball's come back on the Hoyk side. It's with Neil Rennick now. Neil Rennick breaks the two tackles there. Neil Rennick, he's away down that far side of the park, and he's only got the one player to beat. Steps inside him, and unfortunately spills the ball forward just in the tackle there. We've played 7.5 minutes of this second half. Jed 0, Hoyk 36. Neil Rennick was away down that far side of the field, but the tackle coming in from Dan Gillespie, and unfortunately Rennick just spilled the ball forward there, and it's going to be a put in here, and it's got to be a Jed ball. They're deep in their own 22 on the far side of the field. Hoyk playing up towards the bar end, where the biggest percentage of the supporters are, that aren't in the stand. They're all standing outside the bar. They've come outside to watch this final, and big roar going up for Hoyk. Robert Hogg now. Robert Hogg trying to break out his own 22, feeds it to David Gobby. He's been tackled well though, and this ball should come back. In fact, the referee's saying that ball's out there. Bruce McNeil protesting there, and it looks like Bruce McNeil, he's getting a yellow card here. Bruce McNeil yellow carded, because in fact Ian Hurd, the referee's calling him back, because Bruce McNeil's been gesticulating there, and it's all gone a bit silly there, and he's got his yellow card now. And 8.5 minutes played in this second half. Bruce McNeil, Hoyk down to 6 players. Bruce McNeil making his way off the park, but he's still there, and could end up interfering with play here. David Gobby on the break now. He's up to halfway there. He's looking for some support. He's got support on that far side of the field with Robert Hogg. Robert Hogg picks the ball up on the halfway line. feeds it back inside to David Gobby. Gobby on the halfway line now. Where's he going with this? Looks back inside. Darren Gillespie now. He's been tackled. Back to David Gobby. Still on the halfway line here. Feeds it to Gregor Young now. Gregor Young up the stand side. Greg Cottrell gives up the chase, and Gregor Young's going to go in to get the granny off the back there. And it's Jed Forrest now, 5, Hoik 36. Gregor Young going in for the score there, his first try of this final.
Yeah, a consolation score in the last minute of the final, and he walks back. You know, seldom will he score a try, touch the ball down and look so despondent after doing so in a game. But yeah, that was an opportunity for Jed at least to get some points on the board. We'll see if they can convert here. That's not a bad effort at all. It has been successful, so that moves them on to 7 points, 36-7. Still a very handsome victory for the home side.
It certainly is indeed. And referee, we've played almost 10 minutes of the second half, but the referee's saying no, we've got some time to play on. So here we go, the ball's just been dribbled forward there, and I think in fact Keith Davis, I think it was a knock on, but the referee's just let it go. And Neil Rennick's hacked that ball through, and it's a foot race now. Neil Rennick playing a bit of football here, and he looks as if he's going to go in the corner. Neil Rennick is indeed. Has he touched it down? Or is the assistant behind saying it? The fact the assistant's saying that the Jed player Ian Chisholm got there in front of him. But the final whistle goes here on a tremendous victory for Hoik. 5 in a row it is now, 7 finals in a row, 5 in a row for Hoik. 36-7, they've beaten Jed Forrest in this final. Absolutely tremendous stuff. 6 tries, 3 of them from Greg Cottrell. That's 6 tries for Cottrell during the entire tournament this afternoon. Hoik, they've come through this tournament very, very easily, you have to say. Beaten Berwick 31-7 in the first round, then the quarter-final 38-10 against Peebles, and then 36-10 against Selkirk, and now running out winners against Jed Forrest, 36-7.